Hello everyone, welcome to edupediaworld.com. This is your video lecturer Vomika Soni, and in the current video lecture I will discuss about types of transpiration in a descriptive manner about the three types of transpiration: the stomatal transpiration, the cuticular transpiration and the lenticular transpiration. See, most of the transpiration takes place through stomata. The number, structure, distribution, opening and closing of stomata influence the rate of transpiration. 90% of the total water loss from a plant takes place through stomata. As you can see the image, in the still air, a hemisphere of humid air diffuses out of each stomata. When there are air movements, the diffusion shell is blown away and replaced by drier air. This maintains the water potential gradient and increases the rate of transpiration. See, you can see the spongy mesophyll cells, the cell wall of the cell, the cytoplasm, the vacuole, the epidermal cell, the cuticle, the guard cell and the diffusion shell of humid air develops in still condition can be seen in this image. See, stomata are microscopic parts consisting of two kidney shaped guard cells. In stomatal transpiration, water vapor moves through the stomata of leaf. Water absorbed by the roots rises through the stem and reaches the tissues of the leaves through veins. A large number of spongy mesophyll cells in the leaf have their surfaces exposed to the intercellular spaces. The surfaces of the cells give out some of the water, which forms a thin film. The water from this film evaporates and the water vapor formed saturates in the intercellular spaces. This vapor then diffuses into the other connecting intercellular spaces and finally reaches substomatal space, from where it escapes out through the stomata. Stomata are absent in submerged hydrophytes. Light, water, temperature and carbon dioxide concentration affect stomatal opening. Some example of hydrophytes are hydrilla and vallisneria. Now the stomatal regulation of transpiration. See, transpiration occurs as long as the stomata are open. It stops when they are closed. We all know about it. And you can see here the closed stomata, how these flaccid guard cells are present here and due to which the stomata is closed. And in the other section you can see the open stomata. Here the guard cells are turgid and the stomata is open. The wall of the stomata is thick. And here you can see the thin cell wall. Okay. Next is, the opening and closing of stomata depend upon the turgid or flaccid state of guard cells. When the guard cells are in flaccid state, stomatal apparatus closes. During the daytime, as a result of photosynthesis, concentration of carbohydrates rises, leading to osmotic uptake of water by guard cells to swell. Since the wall of guard cells towards stomatal opening is thick while the outer convex wall is thin, inflow of water in the guard cells causes them to bulge outwards, thus widening the stomatal opening. When the osmotic pressure of guard cells become lower, water leaves these guard cells due to exosmosis. What is exosmosis? It is the outward movement of water and moves to the neighboring epidermal cells having cell sap of higher concentration. The guard cells become flaccid and shrink, and stomatal aperture closes. So this was all about the opening and closing of stomata. It was the regulation of transpiration of stomata. Now we will discuss an experiment which will demonstrate the transpiration in plants by the use of cobalt chloride paper. This is a very important experiment, and please listen carefully the procedure and the observation and the explanation of the observation which will be given in the end of the experiment. We have to demonstrate the transpiration in plants by using cobalt chloride paper. Then here are the requirements. A bell jar is used, the potted plant, wooden sticks, thread, cobalt chloride paper, and a polythene bag. What is the procedure? You have to enclose the pot completely within a polythene bag and tie the mouth of the bag firmly around the base of the stem. Then what we have to do, we have to keep the piece of dry cobalt chloride paper by the side of the plant and place the entire plant inside the bell jar. See, we have to place the entire plant inside the bell jar. Here we have kept the cobalt chloride paper, and here is the wooden stick that is kept. Okay. Then in the second bell jar, only a piece of cobalt chloride paper is kept. And the first bell jar contained the plant also. But here we have not kept the plant. We have only kept the piece of cobalt chloride paper. Now keep both the jars together in sunlight. After keeping both the jars together in sunlight, we have to wait for an hour. Then after 1 hour, what we see? We see that the water drops can be seen inside the bell jars. Okay, due to which the cobalt chloride paper turns pink. But in the case of the second bell jar, the cobalt chloride paper is still the same. There is no change seen in the second bell jar containing cobalt chloride paper. See the observation, the first bell jar would show water vapor condensing on its inner wall. At the same time, the initially blue cobalt chloride paper in it would turn pink. What is the inference or the explanation of this experiment? The second bell jar in this experiment is a control which proves that there was no moisture in the air. Okay, and the first bell jar showed that there was moisture in the air, due to which the cobalt chloride paper inside the first bell jar, it turned into pink. So this experiment proved that since there was no plant in the second bell jar and there was plant in the first bell jar, the cobalt chloride paper present in the first bell jar, it turned into pink. But in case of the second bell jar containing no plant inside it, there was no change seen in the cobalt chloride paper. Next, we will discuss about the cuticular transpiration. See, to minimize water loss, the upper epidermis of most plant species secrete a thin layer of wax. Okay, this thin layer of wax is called the cuticle. Primarily, the cuticle serves to prevent evaporation of water from leaf surfaces. Now, greater the thickness of cuticle, what will be less? The transpiration is less. Okay, here you can see the image of a section of leaf showing a cuticle. See, here is the epidermis. Here are the stomata. Here are the hairs you can see. And here it is the vascular bundle. Here we can see the thick waxy cuticle. And this shows the section of a leaf showing cuticle. Next is the last type of transpiration. It is called the lenticular transpiration. See, lenticels are specialized openings that develop in older stem in the place of stomata. Okay. Now, water from the cell surface directly facing the lenticel evaporates and contributes to transpiration. See, this was all for today's video lecture. We have studied about the different types of transpiration, and also we have seen an experiment in which we have used cobalt chloride paper. It turned pink due to moisture produced by the plant kept inside the bell jar. Then we have seen the different types of transpiration properly. In my upcoming video lecture, I will describe about the factors affecting transpiration. Please keep watching to edupediaworld.com to all the videos of Edupedia World, and have a wonderful day ahead. Thank you very much for listening to this video.